Guys, welcome back after a very long time.
For a sit-down video, it's been like really long. Exactly. And the last one, I think we did a very similar video
last time we
did a sit-down. And that's obviously doing really well. And y'all have so many more questions.
Yeah.
And we didn't have answers at that time, but we're back. We are informed and we're back to give y'all an idea. So this video is mainly about VITEEE, which is...
I don't know.
It is VIT engineering entrance examination.
Yeah, so then we like properly well, in my defense, I didn't write it, so I don't know. So then we thought we'll do like a cute little sit down video for y'all wherein we tell you more about like VITEE in general, the result part, the admission parts, how to apply and basically about the examination in general. So this video is going to be about that. Yep. Stay tuned because we have more videos coming up about VIT.
More vlogs.
Exactly, more vlogs
tours,
particularly.
And all of that. Then.
So because we'll be going back to VIT.
Very soon, very excited.
So we will, you know, go ahead and film some really, really cute vlogs for y'all.
Before we start, this video is sponsored by Edioscope, so you guys should check them out. We'll let you guys know more about them later on in the video, so stay tuned for that.
Let's get into the video. Okay, so we're going to start with the registration process as to how to like apply for the examination. And if you're doing an engineering course in VIT, you have to write VITE. Yep. There is no escaping.
Yeah. You have to. You actually don't have to give JEE, You can give VIT directly, and that's pretty much enough for your admissions. So, and that obviously your 12th grade results as well.
Now, coming to the registration part. So, you have to register via the official website, which is viteeee.vit.ac.in. So, you will have like all the details mentioned. So, we will show you how to do it.
Basically, you have to fill in your name and your gender, mobile number, date of birth and all that other details, then you'll get like a mobile number verification, your email verification and stuff, and that's pretty much how you start your registration process.
The dates have not been announced, but it'll mostly be April 2024 only this year. So you know, tentative dates is what we have found out. So it should be April ending or
mid to end April.
That is when the exam will be. So there are four stages of application. So as soon as you open the website and click on apply, you'll have four different stages. As she mentioned, all the process after that, there are these four stages.
Personal information is the first stage. So basically you have to give your parents details and your hometown, your mother tongue and all that. Then there's educational information, obviously your school, your background, 12th grade and all that. Then there's the fee payment one. So there'll be like a small amount that you have to pay for the registration of the exam, obviously. And this is a non-refundable amount. You will not be able to get it back even if you're not writing the exam. And the final step is to submit your photo and your signature as well. And once this is done, you will have this application number. Not even before this is done, you'll basically get like an application number. This is important for your results also later, so you need to keep this in mind. It's important. So
that's pretty much it for
the application part.
Registration part is all this.
So once you're done with all this, technically you're registered and they'll email you or they'll text you about, you know, your dates and your exam cities. You can give your preference as well, where you'd like to take the examination. Most probably you'll get your first preference itself usually. It's not that much of an issue. So.
That's how
you register.
Yeah, that's the good first luck. Segment. So coming to the examination part of this video. So this examination is fully computer based. There are five sections here. So you have physics, chemistry, math or bio, English and aptitude. So these are the five sections that are there. And the weightage is more for math. And slash biology,
math or bio, whatever you're choosing. We'll let you know what that is.
And the exam duration is around 2 hours 30 minutes. So that's that. And you have 125 questions, all are MCQ. There is no negative marking, all one mark questions.
So just attempt as much as you can. Yeah. Just attempt everything, even if you don't know it, just like
guess. You study and come.
If you all want to get it, like obviously there'll be a lot of competition. So prepare well. If you all are doing JEE, actually it's pretty simple.
We are preparing for JEE, I think.
My rank is really bad, so I can't say anything. So, like we were saying, you can either do PCM or PCB. So, here's the thing. If you want like a bio-related engineering subject, so for example, biotech, you can choose to write PCB exam, which is physics, chemistry, biology, instead of physics, chemistry, math. So what that's going to let you do is, it's going to let you take bio-related courses only once you get your rank. On the other hand, if you do like a math exam, so PCM and aptitude English, then you can do any engineering course. So even biotech you can take if you take write the math exam. So I think you have more options if you do the math exam. But if you really don't want to do and you know exactly what you want to study, then I suggest you go with biology.
Yeah.
Then at least you know the subject also. Exactly. You'll, you know, guarantee yourself a better rank as well.
So for the individual questions, number of questions for each subject, physics has 35 questions, chemistry also has 35 questions. Math, as I said before, also more weighted, so that is 40 questions. Then similarly, bio also has 40 questions. Yeah. Then aptitude has 10 questions and English has 5 questions. So totally, yep, 1 mark each, so 125 questions totally. So that's the examination part, so that segment is over. So now we shall take a tiny minute to thank our sponsors.
Yes.
We'll introduce our sponsors now and we'll let you know what they do.
So Eduscopes is basically a leading admission consultant for Indian universities. They'll give you information about all the leading colleges in India, including VIT, SRM, Manipal, Christ University. There's a lot more. You can go and check out their website as well for more information. Exactly how you have so many different organizations that will help you with abroad colleges, Eduscopes is just an organization that's going to help you with all the Indian colleges. And I'm sure a lot of you are coming from your 12th grade, you're so confused on how you're going to proceed with it. And this is going to give you so much more information. And it's so much more better. And I really wish it was there when we were applying. Yeah. Because it's honestly really convenient for us as well.
So if you want to join VIT and you think that your rank is not that great, you can contact Eduscopes for direct admissions as well. They will give you information about the fees and all other details regarding VIT. So you can get your admission hassle-free. So you can contact them for more information.
Yeah, they'll also provide you with more information about the direct admissions to VIT without the whole, tension about your rank and all that. So it's so much more convenient as well.
Check out their website.
Check out eduscopes.in for more details. Alright, so now coming to the results. Obviously, it's going to take a while, I think. Not much though, maybe.
Yeah.
If you write your exam, I think end of April, probably May 1st week, 2nd week max, you'll probably get the results. And they let you know by email or text or something, they let you know that the results are out.
Yeah, so once you want to see your results or whatever, just go to you log into the website, add in your application number, date of birth, and then you click on submit and then get the results. You can download or print the results and keep it safely with you.
Now, to the segment that actually matters, coming to your admissions part. So once you get your results, the results will be in form of ranks. And the ranking, if you get a 5-digit rank, please don't worry only.
Yeah.
It's like the ranking is for all the students who've taken VIT in general. It's not per subject or per course or whatever. It's just a general ranking. So the only thing is your fees is dependent on your ranking. It's heavily dependent on your ranking. And the more numbers you have in your rank, the more numbers you'll have in your fees. So if you have any queries and all, obviously you can contact Eduscope. They'll obviously guide you with this. Obviously, a lot of people are asking, how much rank is the best? What is the cutoff? So cutoff is technically, there's no cutoff. It also depends on a lot of things. You will get your rank regardless. You'll have a rank, and then depending on the category, you'll be placed in a few categories depending on your rank. So 1 to 20, likewise, that we'll explain later. But then once that's done, you have to go ahead with your admission. That is your choice. Depending on your fee structure and everything, you can go ahead with the admission or not.
Exactly.
So technically what we're trying to say is there's no cutoff. It's just your fees are going to be higher if your ranking is more. That's all. All right.
Yeah.
So basically this ranking will depend on obviously the number of candidates and how well they do in their exams and all that as well, plus the difficulty, how difficult the exam is, and then depending on the seats and who and all decide to show up and take admission, it's gonna differ your chances and everything.
So there are 5 different categories when it comes to the ranking. So your ranks, as in, I'm gonna tell it based off the ranking as such and not any other
marks
or anything, because that's completely dependent on your pool of people or whoever's writing the examination. So 1 to 20k is category 1,
mm-hmm.
Then 20k to 40k is category 2, 40 to 65 is category 3, 65 to 99.9k is 4, and 1 lakh onwards it's 5. So these are the different categories that are there, and depending on your rank you'll fall into one of the categories and will be called for counseling.
The first category will have the first 100%. Preference, the second category second, and likewise. So counseling is a whole other hassle. You have things to take for your counseling and all of that. So like we said, basically we are doing biotech, but we are doing MSc integrated biotech, which means our admissions were totally purely based on our 12th grade marks alone.
Yes.
There was no exam, entrance exam or anything. So we're not the best people to be talking about this, even though the information we have here right now that we've given you is pretty accurate because we've done our research. Other than that, you can obviously contact EduScope Store, and for more information, they'll be the best people to guide you.
That's pretty much it for today's video. We're done. We hope you you know, got some information that you were looking for, and we hope we were able to help you enough. So
if you guys have more questions, do let us know in the comments. We'll try and answer to the best of our ability, and if the number of questions are extremely high, obviously we'll make another video for y'all. We'll answer as much as we can. So obviously drop your questions in the comments, and we will see you guys next time with hopefully like a vlog or something more fun and entertaining. So
stay tuned.
All right, see you guys next time. Bye.